Hello everybody, my name is Walter and today I want to show you how you can build my simple and compact 5x5 wall trapdoor, which you can see right in front of you. As you can see, it looks like a simple 5x5 chute going straight down with a lever to the side, and if I flick that lever, the whole thing here closes up really fast, as you can see, into this nice looking walled trapdoor design, which is, by the way, not replicated at the bottom. But anyway, once I flick the lever again, the whole thing opens up really fast once more, and I'm back to the flat chute again. And that's basically what the thing does. Now with that out of the way, let's go and talk about the sizes. So as you can see, it has an 11 by 11 footprint, and the door itself is also only 5 blocks high, 6 blocks if you count the floor itself, which makes this a really compact design actually. And with that, let's get straight to the resources. So of course you need some building blocks, then 16 obsidian blocks, 7 stein blocks, 26 redstone dust, 3 redstone torches, 10 repeaters, 8 observers, 9 normal pistons, 22 sticky pistons, 3 node blocks, and then of course a lever as an input, and maybe some additional redstone wire to relocate the lever to somewhere where you can actually reach it. And that's pretty much all you're gonna need, so let's get straight to building this trapdoor here. Okay, so the first step is marking the very center of the trapdoor with a normal block, 3 layers below the floor level, as you can see here. Then let's go down one layer, place another 2 blocks to the side, then a obsidian block there, then you can remove 2 3 blocks again, add another 3 blocks until you get this T-shape, and then a raised obsidian block to either side, like so. Then in this corner we need a lowered block with a raised block next to that, then place 4 blocks down there, a raised block here followed by 3 normal blocks, lowered one layer, then around the corner another 2, put down 5 redstone dust here, another 3 in there, then a repeater on 2 ticks here, here and on 4 ticks in there. In this gap we need a normal piston towards the side, an observer on top of this redstone dust there with a block and redstone dust on top of that. Then here we need a block in front of the repeater, torch on top, block on top, torch to this side, then diagonally to the torch we need a block with some redstone dust which would connect with this torch, then a block on top and to this side, redstone dust there and next to that another raised block, then a node block right there, put down 2 observers as you can see here, then we need another 2 normal blocks there. Next, let's go towards this gap here and place first 3 sticky pistons there, then on top of that 3 normal pistons, then diagonally to that another 3 sticky pistons. Next, let's go and grab 3 slime blocks, place them in front of those sticky pistons, then 2 normal blocks there and a 2x3 of normal blocks on top of that. Then let's go towards the back and simply power this redstone line there. And what we want to see is this little staircase here essentially, and if we unpower this, the whole thing should now flatten out, as you can see there. With that, this front part is already done, so let's simply fill in the rest of this wall. As you can see here. Then it's next time to start the 2 sides. So now for the sides, since they are built pretty much the same, just mirrored, I will show you how to build a redstone and then mirroring during a cut towards the left. Anyway, let's start right diagonally to this obsidian block here with a normal block, then another normal block there, followed by 2 obsidian blocks, then raised obsidian blocks to either side, another obsidian block towards the outside right there, then go down one layer, place 2 blocks here, followed by another 3 blocks there, raised block with a node block here, then put a repeater on 2 ticks there, followed by 4 redstone dust here, which should connect with the front module at this position here, and on the opposite side it's with this raised wire there. Then let's go and place a normal piston in this direction in this gap. Grab some observers, place one on top of the node block and a repeater. Blocks on top. Another block to this side with some redstone dust there. Then let's go and first place 2 sticky pistons back there. Normal pistons on top, then a sticky piston here and 2 towards the front there. Then let's go and place 2 slime blocks down there, followed by normal blocks in front of the slime blocks and pistons, and then you can essentially fill in the rest of this entire wall here with normal blocks. And that's pretty much this side done. So let's give a simple test run. That's what we want to see. So the closing works actually. Then let's see if the opening works, and that's also working. And then let's quickly mirror this towards the left. And with that, it's finally time for the back wall. For that, let's start on this left side here with a little modification to the module by simply removing this normal piston here and replacing it with a sticky piston. Block to the face of it, block below that, torch right there, then next to the torch a block with redstone dust on top, then raise blocks to either side, a lowered block here, followed by another three blocks to make this T-shape there, then a raised block here and there, followed by a lowered block here and another raised block there, until you get this pattern here. Put down two redstone dust like so, then two repeaters on one tick here, another one on two ticks there, then an observer on top of this repeater there, redstone dust on top, then we need a block to either side of the redstone dust, then a lowered block here with a repeater on one tick there, another lowered block with another repeater on one tick there, then a raised and lowered block here with finally some redstone dust there. Then let's simply place a double piston extender here, followed by three simple sticky pistons right there, and then you can essentially fill in the rest of this wall with normal blocks, as you can see here. And with that done, it's time to give it a test run. So let's simply flick the lever, and that closing works already. And as you can see, it also opens properly. And with that, the final part is essentially filling in the floor and relocating the lever to somewhere else. And voila! So anyway, that was how you can build my simple and compact 5x5 volt trapdoor. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya!